What's up, you guys? Little Red 6.0 here, back here again with another video. Make sure you go down and subscribe and catch me at the Valley meet on the 23rd this weekend on Saturday night. Today we're going to be installing those rock lights I've been talking about. We got 16 of them. I kind of let you guys down on this one. I already installed half of them. It's a long process and I only could install half before I was like, I need a break. So we're back here like 2 days later and we're going to slap the rest on. And yeah, it should be pretty cool. So I got the new RBGWs, the newest ones from McTuning. They're pretty tight. So they're super bright and they're supposed to, they're the RBGW, so that means there's a true white light in there. It's not the rainbow color. So it's basically any color in the rainbow and a true white you can get. I think it's supposed to be like, you're supposed to get like up to like 4,000 colors. I don't know, all kinds of crazy stuff. But it's got a ton of crazy modes. It's all Bluetooth to my phone, so no more having it on a switch. When I had my other ones on a switch, I didn't like it too much because my key always had to be in the run position. So if I wanted to run into the store or something and leave them on, kind of had to leave my key in on the run position. And I mean, yeah, that kind of ain't too fun. But these ones are just hooked straight to the battery and they're Bluetooth to my phone, so I can be about 40, 50 feet away and click that thing on and just leave it for however long I want until I come back with the Bluetooth and turn it off. But yeah, so without further ado, let's hop right into this. All right, so before I hop under the truck and show you guys where I already got the first eight, I got a total of 16, eight on one side, eight on the next. They're gonna be on different modules, so one whole side is gonna be on one module, the other side is on another module. So in all reality, I can run like half red, half blue, and I think that'll look pretty tight. I mean, I don't know anyone else who's can do that one. So yeah, we'll go ahead and show you guys where I got the ones that are already on. So there's our first one underneath the back bumper, kinda. There is our second one that's right underneath the wheel well. There it is, right there, right under the wheel well. Then we go back right here, there's gonna be one right under the bed, right where the cab meets the bed on this. And then we got one right here under the back fourth door. Then we got one right here under the front door. Then we got one right here under that wheel well, under the front wheel well. Then we got one under the front cross member right here. And then we got one in the grill right there. So with them being in all those locations, it's definitely gonna glow all the way around the truck. And the one in the grill is just kind of like a little extra added touch that I want to do. I've been thinking about it for quite a while. I think it'll look pretty cool once I got the grill on and it's all lit up at night. It should be pretty sweet. So yeah, let me hop into the box and show you guys what we got here. We open her up here. What do we got here? We got all the lines. We got the hardware, which I don't use. I use self-tappers, but we got the little rubber mounts. Then we got the actual module itself right here. Then we got our wires that go to the battery. And then we got our lights right here. These are super heavy duty. I'm really liking them, but it's got a nice fat LED up in there. And yeah, basically here's all our lines. So basically what I do to make it easier on me after doing the one side, I'm gonna go ahead and remove all the lines from the module and actual harness that it is, so I can have each light separate from itself. And then I'll take it to its position and I'll run it back that way. Just makes it easier so they're not all kind of together. And then I'll once it's all mounted up, they're all mounted, and then I mount the module, I'll run them all to the module and it'll be clean. So yeah, let's get into it.
All right, so as you can see, I'm under the truck right now. I'm gonna be mounting the module first, get it all self-tapped in, let it hang there, and then we'll run everything to it. So right here is where I mounted that first one in between the two doors. And as you can see, I got it all hanging down still. I gotta retie it all up, but that's where I'm gonna be mounting the other one too, same spot. So there she is mounting right up in there. Same place I had the other one. We got both leads of our harness going in. So then this will just go up towards the frame into the battery afterwards. And these will run down each side. Four will go that way, four will go this way.
All right, so fast forward a little bit and we got six of the eight put on. All I gotta do is slap the one under the front cross member on, and then the one in the grill, and I'll film that one for you guys. But I actually was able to bust them out a little bit faster than the first time because obviously I learned a lot from doing it. So yeah, I already had my spots all lined up too and everything. So I just went up, drilled them, self-tapped them in, and now I got all the wires hanging underneath it, and I just gotta put them all together and run them along the frame and clean them up. Yeah, like I said, we got that one under the back bumper, we got the one in the wheel well, we got the one under the bed, we got the two under the doors, and we got the one under the front wheel so far. Now we gotta throw in the one right there under the front crossmember and the one in the grill.
Alright, so I wanted to show you guys this one. I centered the rock light over this hole, and then I just run the wire straight up through there, and then straight up into the engine bay and then down the frame. So yeah, that just makes it a lot easier.
Just a little tip.
Money! Yeah, that bitch ain't going
nowhere. All right, guys, so, ooh, that lighting. Anyway, got the grill pod on, I got the front crossmember bar on, or the pod on. Anyway, I got the wires ran, they're going up through into the engine bay and then down the passenger side firewall and coming out the wheel well, and then I'm just gonna run it straight back to the other lights on the frame. So let me show you guys.
From that general area, and they're coming up right through here, there's the grill right here, and then here, this one is the one on the cross member. It's going straight back all the way through here, and it's dumping right there. I don't know if you guys can see, it's dumping right there, going down. And then if you get under the truck, it's coming out right there. We got both of our wires, boom, right here. Then we're just gonna run it straight back like that, all the way to the module probably. That'll be perfect.
All right, so now that all the lights are on, I'm gonna go ahead and run all the wires along the frame and stuff and get them to the module. And then I'll probably do a time lapse of me putting it all together on the module. And then, yeah. So, catch you guys back in a minute.
All right, so I got all the wires ran from back there. That one's running under the frame right through there, coming out. And it is coming out right up there along with the wheel well one. It's coming out, coming right in here through there, and then it's gonna all zip tie up and go straight to the module right there. And then our fronts, the wheel well light's coming out from right there, ran it from the wheel well to the frame, and now it's coming out right through here, and then it's gonna join up with these two that were in the front and zip tie all up here, and then meet up with this one under the front door and go to the module, and those four will be ready to go.
All right, guys, so we're back again. This is day two of the install. Yesterday I had to go to the lake right in the middle of filming this video, so our time kind of got cut short, but Don't worry, we're back. And all we got to do is tap everything into the module, splice the two wires together to the battery, and then zip tie everything up clean and turn it on. So let me show you what I got here so far. All right,
so I got my positive and negative ready to go to the battery. I ran it straight down the backside all the way where the rock lights, where I ran the rock light wires down in. Down there, coming out right here through the wheel well. And then everything is ran straight to the box right there. So everything's kind of just dangling around the box.
All I gotta do now is zip tie everything up from where it's ran, hook it to the box, bundle all my extra wire up, and get it up zip tied clean, and then connect to the battery, and we should be ready to go. So yeah, I'm gonna do a little time lapse of me hooking the box all up so you guys can see that. So let's get into that. Alright, so we got everything all hooked up, zip tied up. I just need to get some electrical tape around where I spliced into the box. So on both sides I got the box leads hanging down. I'll zip tie those up after I get them all electrical taped up. And right now I'm going to go ahead and get everything on the battery and butt connector it in, and then we'll get it to the battery. And then we'll be ready to blow, or we'll be ready to go. All of them will be working now. Alright, so we got everything ran, everything wired up, everything zip tied up, everything is ready to go. I'm just gonna wait till it gets a little bit darker so I can show you guys everything in full effect. And yeah, it should be pretty sweet. So we'll catch you guys in a second. Later.
Alright guys, so there it is. All 16 of them. Two in the grill, two up front. One in each wheel well, and three down the sides, and one behind the back bumper.
Alright guys, so that's going to be the end of the video. If you want to see more of those rock lights and more of the truck, go ahead and follow me on Instagram at littlered6.0, all one word. And yeah, catch me this Saturday, probably when this video is coming out, so it'll be this Saturday. And I'll be at Rally on the Valley Saturday the 23rd. Catch me there with my homie DWalsh6.0 on Instagram. It's going to be pretty sweet. We're going to be doing a collab. Make sure you go ahead and subscribe to his channel and check him out, because if you like my content, you're definitely going to like his. He's a rad dude, and he puts out some sweet stuff. So make sure you go follow him and check out his truck. He's got a white 6.0 lifted, like I think he said 4 inches on 36s, and she's wide. She's bad too. She's looking good. He's also like one of the like two people I know, two or three people that has this custom Ford grill that says Ford on it, like in big letters, and it's pretty tight, so that's all custom and it looks sweet. So yeah, make sure you check him out on YouTube, and make sure you like, comment, subscribe to my video, And we'll catch you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Later.